Ito po yung ano no, ito yung mga nangyayaring mga mysteries of the Holy Rosary. we have a very curious incident happening event na nagpalit po ng chief of staff after 5 months, no? So mula kay Baccaro mula kay Centino napunta kay Baccaro, napunta ulit kay Centino. Based on your experience, has this ever happened before, Senator?
None that I know of, ano? Wala akong nalalaman na nangyari na yung ganito.
Mm-hmm.
Tinanggal yung isang chief of staff, pinalitan ng one, tapos tinanggal itong pumalit at ibinalik yung tinanggal.
Opo.
This is a first time in the history of the Armed Forces of the Philippines.
But this is, of course, it's very strange, you know, and we would understand it kung ibang presidente yung nag-appoint initially.
Hello.
Apo, can you hear us, Senator?
Yan.
Okay. Yung kung isang presidente po ang involved dito, si President Bongbong Marcos, ano? So siya yung nag-appoint kay Centino, kay General Centino. Tapos ni-reappoint and in-appoint si Baccaro, and then inibinalik si General Centino. So since you're saying na you've never heard of something like this before, meron bang tinatayo ang basis para mangyari ito as far as you're concerned, Senator?
Wala. Ito is now... Hello?
Go ahead, please, sir.
Hello. This is now raising a lot of questions, ano? And they must be provided answers to hold off any possibility of a coup.
Uy.
Or destabilization.
Mm-hmm.
Na nangyari, halimbawa, doon sa pangungulo ni President Cory Aquino at saka President Arroyo,
mm-hmm.
Gloria Arroyo. There must be answers to questions that need to be answered to hold off any possibility of some groups using this issue to destabilize the government.
Mm-hmm.
Halimbawa,
yeah, go ahead, please.
Una katanungan, mayroong bagong batas yung Republic Act 11-7-0-6 na nagbinigay ng fixed term for the chief of staff and other 7 officers of the armed forces of the Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
Ang katanungan, kailan ba ito effective? Mm-hmm. Naging effective? Kailan na naging effective?
Mm-hmm.
And based on report that Baccaro, General Baccaro, would be the first AFP chief of staff to serve under this new law. In other words, siya ay retirable noong September.
Mm-hmm.
September pa last year. Now, hanggang ngayon, siya pa, hanggang kahapon o noong Biyernes, ay siya pa rin ang chief of staff until pinalitan siya ng Centino, ibinalik Centino, General Centino, sa pagiging chief of staff.
Mm-hmm.
So ang katanungan, mula nung September, the assumptions of people was that Baccaro is covered by the new law.
Mm-hmm.
Meaning, fixed term for three years for General Baccaro.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, katanungan, bakit siya binalik? Ay, bakit siya inalis?
Ayun.
Ano?
Oo.
Now, of course, there is this fundamental principle that the president has the prerogative
mm-hmm.
to hire and appoint officers. And the chief of staff is an appointee of the president. And
mm-hmm.
so therefore, maybe what is being invoked here is that basic principle that the president has the power to hire and fire. Pero question dyan, keep things in order, ano,
yeah.
Dapat ipaliwanag ng appointing authority, mm-hmm. bakit pinanggal mm-hmm. yung isa at ibinalik yung isa.
Mm-hmm.
Ngayon, ibinabalik yung isa.
Oo.
Ano? So, these are questions yeah. that must be provided credible and plausible mm-hmm. answers.
Senator Biazon, yung speech ni General Centeno nung siya ay na-reappoint, ano, isa sa mga mensahe niya is sa mga sundalo stop squabbling. One.
That is correct.
Opo. Tapos sunod-sunod ang ano ang mga statements no from the branches of the AFP na everything is okay, we are in support of the reappointment of General Centeno. I mean, usually, kapag nakarinig ka ng ganun, mapapanatag ka, di ba? Pero pag marami na, sunod-sunod ang nagsasabi na, everything is okay, don't worry, lalo kang kakabahan eh. How do you react to that, Senator?
That is the case, especially yung pagkakataon na lumabas yung tinatawag na memorandum ng PNP sa kanilang strike forces, putting them on red alert with the reason that there is a pending instability in the country.
Hello.
Especially involving the armed forces of the Philippines. Kaya iyan, talagang maisaayos ng gusto, nandun ako na yung mga statements ng commander na yung flag officer in command of the Philippine Navy, the commanding general of the Air Force, the commanding general of the AFP that everything is fine.
Mm-hmm.
Have you heard those things before? Especially under nung kapanahunan ni President Cory at saka President Macapagal Arroyo
mm-hmm.
na naging subject ng destabilizing moves, if not an attempt, to overthrow them out of power.
Mm-hmm.
So nadidinig na naman natin yung mga nadidinig natin ng araw.
Oo nga, no?
Pero ako, sa kasalukuyan, ako'y naniniwala na unang-una, there is no rallying issue for the armed forces to be involved in destabilization moves. Ano? Walang issue eh. Number two, except ito nga, itong nangyayari ngayon. Kaya kailangan plantsahin ng gusto ito upang ito ay matahimik at hindi nakakadagdag sa problema natin ng sibuyas.
ang daming problema actually, Senator Pong, no? Hindi lang po yung sa sibuyas. Pero since na-mention niyo po itong memo na yun nga pong lumabas na yung fake memo na ito na nagsasabi na meron daw pong destabilization plot, sa tingin niyo po ba na isa ito sa mga rason kung bakit ibinalik si Centeno sa posisyon na dati na niyang pinanghawakan?
Meron siya problema. Nakakadagdag dyan sa problema na yan.
Mm-hmm.
Hello? Nakakadagdag sa problema na yan. The fact that there is a pending confirmation by the Commission on Appointment for Centeno's appointment as ambassador to
India.
To India.
Opo.
Ano? And under the law, under certain practices, kung hindi batas, ay no one and the armed forces of the Philippines should be possessing or occupying
two positions.
More than one position.
Opo.
Eh yan. Ano ba ang ibig sabihin nito? Nawi-withdraw na ba yung confirmation ni
General Centeno
as ambassador?
Mm-hmm.
No, which is which now?
Mm-hmm.
Siya ba ay recommended ambassador to Russia and the issue is now in the Commission on Appointment
mm-hmm.
or the Chief of Staff. And the Chief of Staff is supposed to be answerable to the Commission on Appointment also. So kung ako ang Commission on Appointment, alin ang uunahin namin?
And isa din pong point na we have to also consider is because Centeno will be reaching the mandatory retirement age ng 56 sa susunod na buwan. Di po ba yan yung mandatory military retirement age? But under the new law, nabibigyan siya ng tatlong fixed term, what law will be followed? will he be retired first? Yun dahil yun po yung nauna na italaga.
That's the problem.
Mm-hmm.
You know, isang question dyan ay, is Baccaro covered by the new law?
Yun.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi, remember, Baccaro was mandatorily retirable noong September. And yet, si Bautista pa siya hanggang January.
Mm-mm.
So, ito ang kailangang maipaliwanag ng maliwanag na maliwanag. Otherwise, magiging pestering question yung mga questions na nandiyan dyan.
Uh-huh.
And could affect the stability of the country.
Yeah. Pero yung stability of course is something that, you know, if you read between the lines mukhang parang merong ang ganun ano dahil sa bakit lahat nagsasabi na no everything is normal. Sandali, hindi ka naman namin tinatanong eh. Ay, ito yung ating ito yung if et sabi niyo nga kanina ipagpalagay natin na si Lieutenant General Bartolome Baccaro was supposed to have been the very first chief na magkakaroon ng 3-year fixed term. Pero nabanggit din po ninyo, Senator Pong, na it doesn't matter because the commander-in-chief will always be the di ba? He can say no, I choose somebody else instead of you. Is that legal?
Basic and fundamental law and practice is this. Yes, the president has the prerogative to hire and fire, including the AFP chief of staff and other officials in the government, appointed officials in government. But especially for the armed forces and the police, for example, no, a proper acceptable, credible reason must be provided why a certain action such as removing a chief of staff is concerned. Otherwise, it can contribute to the existence of instability in government insofar. Alam mo, Peter and Rica, ang armed forces of the Philippines is a government entity that should be stable.
Mm-mm.
Otherwise, instability in the armed forces of the Philippines and the police would translate to instability in the whole country.
Mm-hmm.
Ganun yan, especially the experience of the Republic of the Philippines under former President Marcos, President Aquino, President Arroyo. Remember that all of these things caused not only security issues, but even economic issues.
Yes. And
kaya yan, ito kailangan maayos ng gusto. Kaya nga, ang katanong ko ngayon, okay.
Okay.
The president has the prerogative to hire and fire, but especially for the police and the armed forces, firing must be well explained, especially if the firing is firing for cause.
Mm-hmm.
Ano ang cause? Ayun. Tingnan natin.
Mm-hmm.
When Santino was fired and Baccaro was placed, maraming nagtaas ng kilay. Bakit tinanggal si Centeno, hindi pa naman retirable?
And no reason was also given then, Senator, di po ba?
Ano?
No reason was also given when he was replaced by Baccaro, only the president saying, now with Baccaro on the helm, this is the right leader moving forward. There was also no reason given why Centeno was retired from the position and Baccaro was replaced.
Take a look at this. Take a look at this, Rica. no less than the Secretary of National Defense has quit his post.
Yun.
Because of this
late breaking
issue.
Ah, ganun ba?
So, can you imagine a very senior defense official, the topmost defense official, retiring not because of any issue except this issue?
But Senator Pong, I will hasten to add na tama po kayo, pero defense OIC po si Faustino. So, in other words, he's not a regular secretary yet. So, baaring mas...
He is not yet.
Opo.
But even as OIC, he had the power to control stability in the armed forces of the Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
Eh, yun yun eh. Whether you are OIC or regular secretary, you were given that power, and you are expected to exercise that power for the good of the country.
Opo. What is your reading, sir? Dito sa pagpapalit sa defense, no? Ni Carlito Galvez Jr. Siya na ang bagong defense chief ngayon. What do you think? Is this a good move by the president?
Former General Carlito Galvez had been, remember, the czar?
Vaccine czar.
Acting czar in the COVID issue.
Opo, opo.
You know? And there was no question to his performance. And he has no issue similar to Faustino. Faustino, there is a one-year ban, remember, for appointing to official position a retiring general or soldier. Ano?
Opo, opo.
Si Galvez, walang ganung walang issue. May issue si
Centino po.
Si ano?
Faustino.
Ay, si Faustino. Faustino.
Si Bacaro.
Ah, si Bacaro.
Tama.
Si Faustino po.
Tama. Si Faustino.
Mm-hmm.
Kaya hindi pa siya maging regular Secretary of Defense because of that ban.
Mm-hmm.
So within 1 year, hindi ka pwedeng maging ganito, maging ganun. No?
Bakit siya itinalagang OIC? Meron palang issue na ganun. Di po ba? That's basic and fundamental.
That is basic and fundamental, yes. But you cannot remove, you cannot change the practice, if not legal, power to hire and fire
Apo.
Of the president. Kaya kailangan ito. Hello? Yeah.
Apo, sige po. Go ahead po.
To hire and fire is a basic and fundamental power of a Republican.
Uh-oh.
And not the American party, the Republican form of government.
Yes po.
To hire and fire. Alam mo, nagkaroon kami ng debate ni former...
Oh, we lost Senator Pong.
The number you're trying to call.
We'll try to call him again.
Alaka, Senator. maganda yung
ang dami rin niyang nire-raise na points that can actually question yung mga appointees, di ba? Yung method of appointment.
Sayang, wala siya sa Zoom, no? I want to see his facial expression. Let's get in touch with the senator again. Maganda yung mga points niya because sa totoo lang, having been the former the chief of staff ng AFP, Armed Forces of the Philippines, syempre alam niya yung mga galawan diyan, di ba? Yung mga galawang ito na ulit. Senator Pong.
Hello.
Yeah, okay.
Opo.
Very
glad
good
to have you back po.
Yeah, okay.
All right.
As I was saying, nagkaroon kami ng former Senator Joker Arroyo on the issue.
Opo.
When I was proposing for a fixed term for
very choppy. Can we get a landline kung nasa cellphone si Senator, if you can ano, if you can just move a few paces to your left, parang alam mo kung nasaan siya ano. para ma-testing natin baka mag-improve yung ano, yung signal. Very very ano po, very choppy. Senator, can you try again, please? Saguli, abe.
Oo, sige, balikan natin ulit. So, maybe we can get a more stable connection for this. Pero kasi yun palang, the first point of giving us the reason why, di ba, mo pinalitan. Just months after mo pinalitan siya with somebody else.
Nandun siya eh.
Oo
diba?
Nga eh, di ba?
Nandun siya nung nagka...
Bakit? Walang binigay eh. And nobody's even talking about it. Diba? We've been trying to get statements kahit kanino over the weekend. Wala din partner eh. Nobody's talking about this.
Oh, that's right. You were on board, ano?
Yes. So okay. Why? Why?
Let's try again. Mm-hmm. Senator?
Hello?
Ayan.
Apo, ayan. Better.
Mukhang mas better.
Okay.
All right.
As I was saying kanina, nung trinopost ko yan, yung fixed term for AFP Chief of Staff, ano, nagkaroon kami ng debate ni... Senator Joker Arroyo.
Mm-mm.
Because I was asking for a clearer definition of the reason how an appointed official can be removed by the president. Mm-hmm. Kailangan por cause yan, ano? And properly explained. Ang sabi ni Senator Joker, may he rest in peace, ano, ay mahirap i-define yung power to hire and fire.
Mm-hmm.
Mahirap i-define talaga yan. So we are going by practice.
Which is, don't question the decision.
The president has the power to hire and fire. Any appointed officials, including the officers of the armed forces of the Philippines.
Kaya nga po, so ibig sabihin, the president does not have to justify whatever decision he makes as long as it's not illegal. Tama po?
That is correct.
But,
yun nga ang sinasabi natin dyan.
Mm-hmm.
But, kaya nga, Ang katanungan ay bakit Macaro is already covered by the new law, yung fixed term. Bakit journalist?
Opo. Tsaka,
at pinalitan na siya ni Centino.
Oo. It will still be quite bad kung iba ang pumalit. But it's worse kung yung dating tinanggal.
Ibinalik.
Di ba, may comeback.
That is correct.
Opo.
That is another question.
Mm-mm.
Now, question. Ito nga yung pending question. How long will Centino stay as Chief of Staff? As being covered by the new law, will he be given the... 3 years, or will he be fired when his in the old law mandatory age of 56 comes by February next month, ano? February 4.
Okay. aba, kasante, Senator Pong, ano to ha? This is ano lang, hypothetical lang po ito ha. Because you came from the Senate, you were crafting laws. Halimbawa lang, sabihin ni General Macaro, I will contest this in the Supreme Court. Can he actually do that?
Yes, he can do that. But whether or not the Supreme Court will acquire is another issue, another matter. But normally, the hire and firing power of the president takes precedence. I'm not a lawyer.
Bakit pa tayo nag-craft ng law?
which also brings the question, Senator, no?
Ito naman, ano, past experience, Rica, Peter, experiences nung revolving door policy. Halimbawa, I was being intended by former President Cory to be extended, ano?
Mm-hmm.
Pero ang sabi ko, Mrs. President, hindi ho pwede yan. Pwede, magagawa nyo yan. Pero, sabi ko kang ganyan, baka ho yung instability ng forces will be affected. Kasi remember, the main issue against President Marcos, the old one, ano, was yung extension of 65 generals. And the longest extendee was former Chief of Staff General Espino. He was extended for a total of 13 years
wow.
and 9 years as Chief of Staff because former President Marcos, the old one, could not decide kung sino kay General Ramos o General Bell ang i-appoint niya.
This is past the retirement age na extension yung sinasabi niyo po, Senator.
Ha?
Yung extension na sinasabi po ninyo, extension sa term niya or extension past the retirement age?
Hindi. Extension because I was already retirable at age mandatory, ha?
Mm-hmm.
56.
Yun.
Ano?
Mm-hmm.
And when I reached the 56 years old, since the power had the power or the president had the power to extend kasi naging ano yun eh.
Mm.
65 generals nga under former President Marcos were extended. Yung nga sinasabi ko, the longest extendee was General Espino. May he rest in peace.
If this has been happening before pa, Senator, can nobody from the other branches of the government question the president's power to appoint and to hire and to fire?
You can question, of course, no? Whether or not your question is based on legal situation or not is another matter. So
correct.
That is the reason why when we were debating with Joker Arroyo, Senator Joker Arroyo, I wanted a definite, clear definition of the power of the president to hire and fire.
Yeah.
Sabi ko, kailangan maliwanag ang ating definition. Ano? Sabi ni Senator Joker Arroyo, may rest in peace. Ano? Ay, mahirap gawin yun.
Opo,
because you will be delimiting that power of the president.
Yes, at saka maraming masyado pong elemento, Senator Pong, because it's not only about yung objective characteristics or standards. Siyempre, titimplahin mo din yan, is this guy loyal to me or not?
That is correct.
Di po ba?
Ito ngayon ang question, one of my questions, Peter.
Po.
Ano ang nagbunsod dito sa galaw na ito? Listening to the statements of some Malacanang officials, para bang ang ginawa kay Centino in the first one, ay wrong. Yun ang sinabi niya, wrong. Ano? Kaya, is this now a restitution of that power of President Marcos, which is now being questioned, was this a restitution,
or in a manner of speaking,
or is this a political move? Is this speculation, or is this a speculative move, or is this a political move on the part of the president? Mahirap sagutin.
So, baka ang sinasabi nga po, baka naman, this is only trying to right a wrong. Opo. But before we say thank you, sir, tatlo lang naman tayo nila rin nag-uusap-usap dito, Senator. Let's talk about the elephant in the room. Ano po ang mga naririnig ninyo sa mga kampo-kampo natin?
Okay. I called up some soldiers, ano? Do you know that Baccaro and Centino were not yet in the academy nung nandun ako?
So, bata pa.
Well, he was there kasi he was class, they are both class 88, ano? Classmate ni Mon Mitra yan eh, yung mga yan.
Opo. Ano po mga bulong-bulungan? Kung meron man?
Well, siyempre, being where I have been, hindi ko masasabing ang sagot nila ay sincere. Ang sabi sa akin, wala yan, sir.
Ah, okay.
Sabi ko sa kanila, oh, whatever it is, stay professional as soldiers.
Yun.
So wala pa rin po pala kayong natunugan, Senator Pong, of the reason
wala.
Why.
Wala. Nothing definite.
Senator Pong.
I will have a meeting next Friday.
Ayan. Sige nga po.
With senior officers,
let me know.
Retirees, ano?
Okay.
Advocates for national interest.